Hello, my name is Ryan O'Daniel, and I'm not that smart, but I know somebody who is. Today I'm talking to Adrian Mouat, one of our developer relations engineers here at Chainguard, and we're going to get smart in 5 minutes. Adrian, how do you do?
Yeah, I'm good. Very happy to be here.
Nice. Today we're going to ask the question, what is a container image? What is a container image?
So let's actually start with what is a container? So a container is a way of encapsulating an application and its dependencies so that it's portable and self-contained.
Nice.
Now to make a container, you need your container image. So the container image is basically a file system and a set of metadata that defines what the running container will look like.
Right on. So self-contained, easy, portable, all stuff like that, yeah?
Exactly.
Nice. Let's say I wanted to make a container. What are the components that I'd need?
So most people build containers using a Docker file and the Docker build command.
Okay.
And so the Docker file will have a base image that you start from, and then you will add further things to it, such as data, configuration, and your own application, for example.
Right on. So you take the base image, you build on top of that, and then you have your image.
Yeah, so for example, you might have a Python application that you want to turn into a container, a container image. In that case, you'd probably start with the Python base image, and you'd add your application code into that image, and you'd end up with a self-contained portable container that you can ship to production.
So the base image is a start. I'm guessing it matters which one you choose for what you're trying to do. Is that right?
Yes, very much so. So the most common base images are the Linux distributions themselves. So you have Debian, which is used by a lot of the official Docker images, but there's also things like Alpine, and Ubuntu, and Red Hat. And in fact, we also have our own Wolfie Linux distribution. And you also get images for common applications and platforms, so things like Java, Node, Python, etc.
With all the choices, sounds like it can be a complicated or difficult process. Versus doing it myself, are there places I can go to grab what I need to get started or do things better or differently?
Yes, there is, and that's totally what I'd recommend you do. So you can get pre-made images from something called a container registry, which is a centralized repository of images.
Right on. Are there any notable registries that people generally get their images from?
Yeah, so the biggest one is the Docker Hub, and that's got hundreds of thousands of images that you can look at. But there are also other registries, such as the Google one, and also we have our own Chainguard registry.
Right on. Docker Hub, Google, Chainguard registry, and others. Nice. What factors are important when choosing a container image?
Yeah, so it's important to be careful here, especially if you're going to run the container in production. The first thing I would look at is who created the image. Do you trust them? Then I would check if it's up to date. Like, has the image been created recently, and do they keep it up to date with the latest releases of the software? And then I would also guide people towards minimal images. So minimal images typically have less in them, so they're easier to transfer about, and they also typically have less vulnerabilities. And that's the final thing I would do. I'd run a scanner on the image to check the number of potential vulnerabilities in the image. And typically you want to choose an image that's got less vulnerabilities.
Because from a security standpoint, it's safer, it's less risk, is that right?
Yeah, exactly. And I have great news for you. If you want one of these, do go and check out the Chainguard image registry.
Right on. There you have it. Now we know what a container image is. One last question for you, Adrian. What's your favorite aquatic animal?
I'd say a rockhopper penguin. I mean, have you seen those guys?
Are they jacked?
Oh, yeah.
There you go, folks. We just got smart in 5 minutes. We'll see you next time.
Fantastic.
I don't know what to answer that.
Are they jacked? I don't know.